your hands together for Jesus. You can do it better and better and better. Put your hands together one more time. Amen. Ask someone, are you ready for God tonight? Come on. Look at your neighbor that's sitting by you. Are you ready for God tonight? Please ask someone for me. Are you ready for God tonight? Turn to another person. Are you ready for God tonight? Amen. We are ready for God. Do it one more time. And the man of God is in the house. Put your hands together for Jesus. Amen. Yesterday night was very powerful. Partition service with Reverend Steve Mensah. Amen. Very, very powerful. But I'm telling you, tonight is going to be something else. Amen. And before that, I have a man of God, a very good friend of mine, Madame Fopa, from International Palace Church. Very good brother. Put your hands together for Reverend Frank Asare. Put your hands together for him. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. And we were another sister. And she's a sister. Minya Prekope. Amen. And from International Palace Church, very good singer, songwriter, choir leader. Amen. They pronounce them so much because yin together. Yin me home for many years. So by the grace of God, yin yasan with ministry so we are always happy whenever we see ourselves. Before our suffering rebana, I want her to give us one song. She will sing us a song, trust me. Amen. So without wasting, and please, the husband also is in the house. And you know what? Since Papa Adams is coming Friday, she will come back again. Amen and amen. So without wasting much time, let's welcome Auntie Kekele to give us a song. Put your hands together for her.
Hallelujah, born my Jesus. Nabo amen so na men da so for us. Menu abe ma prekope. Hallelujah. Just wave on to the Lord tonight. Me jiri se amu bebre o ha afi ekwe wie ye. Wa be mu buba e ma wa be mu mu. E san se bo she bi anya me dia she ono e bebe mu. Ka che ni oti wun chen se e bebe mu. Se wu hu ya en che se embe mu. Hallelujah. Yesu wa ma fein. Na wa se mi bo. Wo be di ni bo Jesu. Hey. Yesu wa ma fein. Na wa se mi bo. Wo be di ni bo. Messiah, want my faith. Jana Sissimi. Oh, I want you to know. Yes, you can be born.
Hallelujah. Put your hands together and give God a shout. You can do that. You can do it better. You can do it better. You keep clapping your hands and give the Lord a shout of praise. You can do it better. You can do it better as you are shouting. The walls of Jericho are coming down. Shout unto God. sister can sing and change the atmosphere. Can you feel the anointing? Can't you see the atmosphere is already charged, preparing for the man of God to come? Clap your two hands one more time. Wow. This is the reason why I love my sister so much. Amen. God bless you, Auntie Kekeli. Amen. Be on your feet. The man of God is already in the house. I said the man of God is already in the house. Let me tell you something. Some years back, I met Reverend George, and because he used to be my senior brother's friend in the same ministry, and since the time I who me when I was young boy coming, when you know me famous one day cry, amen and amen, and Libya program, Libya war at that church at that time, he will make sure say I have to be there by hook or crook, amen and amen, and I remember he encouraged me a lot in ministry, telling me many things about ministry. He also asked me to come to the Bible school because he was a teacher by then. Amen. And maybe we do the time of Bethlehem, and we will say everyone is busy because you can't afford to miss him when he's teaching. Put your hands together for us. Full of wisdom, knowledge, understanding. Amen. When it comes to teaching and explaining the word of God. Hallelujah. The man is weight. Amen. Very powerful. And the senior pastor of Wisdom Gate Ministry. Amen. Opposite Maradona. And also, very soon, Oba just around here. Because they are building this giant building. Very powerful, nice auditorium. We are waiting for the dedication and the party. We are waiting for the dedication, but we will be there. And then for the dedication and after that, we join the party too as well. Amen and amen. We thank God for his life, for all the Lord is doing him. He's here, amen, to release oil of exploit upon your life. Are you ready for him? Without wasting much time, let's welcome Reverend George Atiemo. All the way from Wisdom Gate Ministry. Amen.
Amen. Can you do me a favor? The clap offering was very low. Do it to the Lord. Amen. And look at somebody and tell the person you have a great future. Tell another person you have a great destiny. Say, I prophesy to your life that you will not leave this earth ordinary. You surely leave a legacy where generation will come and read it. Catch your busy me. See, won't free us as he's so quiet. Ubeja bibi waha.
Ubeja bibi waha.
Nyamebeka oho.
Nyamebeka oho.
Engosraninti.
Engosraninti.
Odachi yakese.
Odachi yakese.
Wonshebre yakese.
Wonshebre yakese.
Can I hear somebody say amen?
Amen. Tiso bika amen pa.
Amen.
Amen.
How may celebrate your pastor?
Buame na mumbo enyo osafoso.
Hallelujah. There are people, when you even make an attempt not to love them, you still can't do it. From many years, I used to travel with him to Akosombo to have a very big program. Sometimes we'll be on the radio. I travel with him with Koforidia a lot for all nights and
go.
I used to be a shouting preacher. But now I'm aging, so I talk gently. I
call.
Amen.
Amen.
And since you are my neighbors, I always been a bit nosy to see what is going on here. The good news is that I don't see bad things.
Amen.
It simply means this church has a future. Learn to be with your pastor. I read a story currently about a king with many servants. This king is a bit uncharitable, a bit wicked. Anytime a servant offends him, what he do is that he has some wild dogs. Train wild dogs, all they do is that he throw the servants into where the dogs are in order for them to do justice to the person. So
that
is this servant of the king who have served him for almost 10 years, committed and faithful to the king. One day he erred. Then the king said he must be killed. They have to throw him to where the dogs are. The servant begged the king, begged him. The king said, what he has said is final. So this wise servant did something. He quickly went to those who are under supervision of the dogs and said, can you give me 10 days to take care of them? Wash them. Feed them. So with the help of them, they were surprised that with your caliber, you are stepping into this place to take care of the dogs. So he fed the dogs for 10 days. Washed them. Clean their environment. Then he went back to the king for his final execution. So the king instructed them to bind the servant and threw him to where the dogs were. Unfortunately, an amazing thing occurred. The moment the guy landed at where the dogs were, they were so friendly,
sniffing
around the servant, playing with the servant. So the king was amazed. What am I seeing? This is the first time. Because my dogs are very wild. So he asked the servant, do you have any voodoo? And he said, no.
I said, Dabi,
I serve you for 10 good years. My little mistake, you want me to be rewarded this way.
But
I took care of the dogs for 10 days. And they have appreciated my service. Sometimes, that is how members of the church are. I meet a lot of pastors. Pastors come to my office with great lamentations from members they have stood for, gave their life, fed them, times of challenges. They canceled them, they did a lot. But let pastor they will forget everything. Sometimes dogs or animals are more appreciative than human beings. Be more appreciative than a dog. Learn to appreciate your pastor. He is a man of God, not a god of man. Bible says John was a man sent by God. Even though he carried God's assignment, but he's still a man. So it is obvious that the mistakes men commit, he can also commit the same. When pastors remember the good times, don't leave the church creating all stories that are not real. Help me celebrate him once again. Amen.
Amen.
Lift up your right hand as we share a word of prayer. Father, we count on your presence. We count on your power. We count on your mercies. Let the blood of Jesus speak tonight. And let heaven answer. Spirit of God, take preeminence. Brood over the whole environment. Let this be an atmosphere of miracles. An atmosphere of healing. Anyone that came here tonight for a sign, give him a sign, Lord. Anyone who came here for deliverance, deliver, Lord. Anyone that came for salvation, Lord, give him salvation. For upon Mount Zion, there shall be holiness. There shall be deliverance. And the house of
Jacob
shall possess their possession. Let tonight be a night of possession, Lord. I submit to you, Lord. I remain a clay in your hands. Anoint these lips. Give me the tongue of the learned. The clarity of speech. Position of thought. To divide your word. Thank you, Lord. For answering prayer. In Jesus' name. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Please take your seat. Take your Bible with me to Psalm number 35, verse 36. I want the King James.
Psalm
35, verse
26.
Let me read from verse 25. Sorry. Verse 25. Let them not say in their hearts, so will we have it. Let them not say, we have swallowed him up. Let them be ashamed and brought to confusion. Together that rejoice in my head. Let them be clothed with shame and dishonor. That magnify themselves against
me.
And let them shout for joy and be glad that favor the righteous cause. Let them say continually, the Lord be magnified, which have the pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. May the Lord bless this
way.
Amen.
Amen.
This evening I'm going to share with you, nowadays I don't preach very long. I'm going to pray on a subject that is connection with a
theme.
The attractions of the oil. Or the attraction of the anointing. There are few things in life that attracts the most. Those things attract the positive and the negative. Example, beauty attracts a lot. Every beautiful Success also attracts. Wherever there is success, there are many friends. But success can also attract the negative. Success attracts enmity. Because one man's success will expose another man's failure. Not everybody will be comfortable about your success. Your success can intimidate somebody. We all live in the same environment, brought up in the same area, and all of a sudden you are booming. And you think they will celebrate you. They will do everything. So success attracts. Anywhere there is success, there is contention. That is how, why your position and placement will determine your opposition. How far God has placed you and how far God has positioned you will determine the things that will oppose you. Great destiny attracts great problems. I hope I'm speaking to somebody. Tell somebody, great destiny will always attract great problems. And another thing that attracts a lot of things is the anointing of the Holy Spirit. The most powerful people do go through problems. Because Satan always attack people he fear the most. I have ever said this thing over and over. That if you are a child of God and you don't go through challenges, attack from the enemy's camp, it is two things. It's either the devil hasn't seen any good thing around you, or it's either you are agent. Are you listening to me? So the anointing of the Holy Spirit attracts many things. It attracts favors. It attracts open doors. It attracts the goodness of the Lord. Anointing simply means divine empowerment. When they say supernatural, supernatural means something that goes beyond the natural. In other sense, in life, there are certain things you cannot do it with your natural abilities. It will take the hand of the Lord to be able to do it. You try and start calling people to meet at your house on Sundays and see whether they will come. So for your pastor to gather this congregation, it's not natural. There is something more than the natural. And I came here tonight with the word of prophecy. That may the Lord empower you this week.
And
what your natural instincts can help you to do. After this program, you'll be able to do. For the people who know their God, they will do exploits. Am I here? Somebody saying
amen.
So anointing attracts a lot of things. Today I'm not talking about that side. But I want you to know that for the fact that you are coming for a fresh oil convention, yes, you receive the oil. But there is a saying that forenoon is forearmed. I hope you hear what I said. I said what? Forenoon is forearmed. It always takes a knowing to decide a going. Anointing attracts It attracts challenges. Look at the writer of the Psalms we read. This particular Psalms was written by David. And if you have read from A to Z, you realize that David lamented about the things he was going through. To the point that the latter part, he was cursing his enemies. He was uncharitable to people that have offended him. Why? Because the guy went through a lot. I have made a research. Since the first church was in session, came into Ibin, I've never seen any person in the Bible who have been anointed for thrice. But David was the only king who was anointed for three consecutive times. The first anointing was in 1 Kings chapter 16, where Samuel, through the instructions of the Lord, came and anointed David. Now hear me. When David has not been anointed by Saul, Samuel, he didn't go through any challenge. He was nice. Even with King Saul. Until the anointing rested on him. And it started attracting greatness. He became a man of valor. He was able to fight against what his master could not fight. Then the enmity started. You want to be anointed, and you don't want problems. Anointing is not for babies. So. When you're ready, say, we wish you how. Don't pray. Some of you are always praying. All anointed people go through challenges. From the day Samuel anointed him for 14 good years, the man has to left his own house, his family, and became a fugitive in the wilderness. And yet there are Samuel, Esra and Wonan obey on Hineo. It taking a bear 14 to 17 years. Not on Namasereso, Nietano. Sometimes you come for revival and they say it's an anointing for this. So you live here and immediately you want things to, move just like that. It doesn't happen that way. After Samuel anointing, in 2 Samuel chapter 2, verse 4, he has to go through the second process of anointing. But he was anointed in Hebron to be a king over Judah. Still, he wasn't becoming a king, only a handful. Until 2 Samuel chapter 5, verse 17 came. Tell somebody, your 2 Samuel 5, 17 is coming. Tell somebody, your 2 Samuel chapter 5, verse 17 is coming. It was after this anointing that now he had an access to be a king. May the Lord anoint somebody tonight. And may this anointing enthrone your destiny. May it empower you. May it lift you to where you have never been in life. Can somebody lift his voice and shout, I receive? But check the scripture carefully. But when the Philistine heard that they have anointed David king over
Israel,
all the Philistines came up seeking David to destroy him.
David,
when When the anointing was not on him, the enemy was quiet. Do you know why? The enemy's master called Lucifer used to be an anointed
cherub.
And whatever he has lost, he doesn't want you to get it. He was an anointed cherub. Very powerful angel. Until the day iniquity was found on him. So Satan always set in his eyes on anyone that carried the same oil. He knows the power of the anointing. He knows what the anointing can do. So he will frustrate you in order to lose it. That is why all anointing seekers must understand this principle. Listen to me. David did not write this scripture for writing's sake.
David, one trust actually and to work again.
David, he went through a lot.
Of fire and near mom and casa.
It came to a time that his own son has to rape his own daughter.
Sir, on no one casa ne ba eso or to ne ba emona.
His own right hand man called Ahithophel.
Na on no one casa ni futu fu a friend Ahithophel.
Conspire with his own son.
Na on ne ba eye ba kon.
Just to empower him.
Overthrown
him from his own throne. His own son has to chase him from his Jerusalem. And I'm
with
him all. It do be a David. He stole the heart of the whole Israel.
Via Israel for you now.
To the sense that for many few years he was then in the world. The sad aspect of it is when I read First Samuel 22. When David was escaping from the hands of Saul,
every Saul and Saul,
there were three types of people accompanied him. I said, First Samuel.
Someone said,
everyone that was in distress, and everyone that was in debt, and everyone that was discontented, gathered themselves to him. Three people.
Were
nobody. Many of them were distressed. Many of them were full of debt. They were discontented in life. They all followed
David.
And you know why? When they followed him, and it got to a time, David was attacked by his opponent. Went somewhere to fight. When he came, the Amaleks has come to ransack everybody in the camp. They've taken their wives and children away. They burned at every place. I thought these people would have been charitable to David. The same people he stood for. When there was nobody in 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 6, Bible says the man that gave consolation to people who were distressed, he himself was greatly distressed. As of
with
the sanity, sometimes with my bar, sorry, no one shame crying. You come to church and encourage people. And you yourself will leave this garage. You pray for people to have their problems met. The people who did follow David were distressed. Full of debts. But many years after they had solution to their problem, David had a problem.
David, so how?
Enemies has taken over. And the same people took a stone
and a far
ready to stone him. They careful about people you hurt, who you help. Let me tell you something. These were people, they were distressed, they were full of debt, and later they became somebody. Now the one whom God used to affect them also had a problem. And the only reward is that to stone the man of God. I'm talking about the attractions of the anointing.
That
sometimes the anointing, all that you can see, and sometimes when you see it, you might think you are not anointed. It attracts problems everywhere. And that is what David went through. So if you look at some of his writings, you realize that he spoke from a bitterness of the heart. And that is where the scripture we read came into being. In Psalm 35, the verse 25. Let's go there. Again.
And
that is my declaration. David went through a lot. Then he said, in this Psalms, and that is going to be a prayer for somebody here. He said, oh Lord, let them not say in their hearts, let them not say. In the midst of all that David went through, he requested for one thing from God. That, oh Lord, I've gone through many times difficulties. Sometimes that is how some of you are. But his prayer was one. That let not the same people say, David became a king.
David
and now he has been a slave. He said, oh Lord, let them not say, he started well, but his end is very bad. Let them not say that David used to be a prosperous person, but now look at his end. Let them not say David used to love God, but now his love is no more. I came here with the same prophetic word to somebody here, that they will not say to you that a great family started well, but they have ended badly. They will not say great family has only remained in only one branch. They will not say that yes, this lady got married, but 4 or 5 years he divorced. Lord, let them not say that he got married, but he cannot give birth. Let them not say he started business well, but now he has ended up with bankrupt. Let them not say that this person used to be a healthy person, but now he is bedridden. Oh Lord, let them not say he used to be in fire for the Lord, but now he has backslided. Oh Lord, let them not say. He said, oh Lord, let them not say he started well, but he has ended bad. That is my prayer for somebody tonight. That is my prophecy for somebody tonight. You will never come to a place where your enemy will say, yes, you married, but you have divorced. They will not say, you have buried your children at your end age. They will not say, you started well, but now look at him. That will not be your portion. Lift your hands and say, my enemies. Say, oh Lord, let not my enemies say, I started well, but I end badly. Can I hear somebody shout the bigger amen? An anointed man went through many problems.
Now how baby mu
to the standard in Psalm 18. He lamented. He said the sorrows of death has compassed around
me.
And the sorrow, he said the flood of the ungodly men have crippled my destiny. That was David.
And not any David.
Anointed man. He left his throne because of the attacks of the enemy. But the solution was one. And I'm just leaving you the solution. That whenever you wake up in the morning in your prayer life, lift your hands after your praise and worship. Tell the Lord, oh Lord, let not my enemies. Said George started well, but he has ended badly. Let them not say the guy died as a pauper. Let them not say. 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 Oh Lord. They will never say. That will never be your portion. He said, let them not say in their hearts, our soul would have it. Let them not say, we have swallowed him up. The enemy will never say, they have defeated you. By the reason of this weak anointing, no witch will say, we have conquered you. No witch will say, they have swallowed you up. No witch will say, they have got you. No agent will say, they have defeated you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Verse 26. But let them be ashamed and brought to confusion. Together that rejoice at my head. Let them be clothed with shame. And dishonor that magnify themselves again. Verse 27. But let them shout. Let them shout for joy and be glad. That favor, I declare that they will now say, hey, so this lady who has no respect in his family and the community, now this is what God has done. He said, let us magnify the Lord, which have pleasure. They will only say, they will only say, you were nobody, but God has made you somebody. They will only say, you used to lack customers. You couldn't sell certain sales, but today people are trooping at your shop. They will say, we thought no man love him, no woman love him, but look at the husband. That will be your portion. They will say, hey.
Yes, Lord.
Let them say now. Tell somebody, let them say, Lord.
Let them say, Lord.
He said, let them now shout for joy. I declare by the Most High God that after this oil conference, the favor coming, even your enemies will even shout for joy. They will shout for joy. Even if they are faking and they are pretending to give a fake smile, a joy will come out of their mouth. That is what I came to do tonight, to prophesy to somebody that let God magnify in your sources. would they not say? Why they shouldn't say
this?
Because Bible says,
John said,
what shall we then say? If God be for us. If God be for us, who can be against us? For the righteous shall fall 7 times, but the Lord will lift him up. For rejoice, not in my enemies. For when I fall, I will arise. When I sit on darkness, the Lord will be light unto us. Why should not say so? Because we have a name that is above every other name. And at the name of Jesus, problems bow. Our challenges bow. Our opponent bow. That name is above all names. Tell somebody. They will not say. Now listen a minute. Say they will not say.
They will not say
that this is your end. No. They will not say this guy died in an accident. They will not say a gas explosion hit him. They will not say that. They will not say that. That his children are dying. They will not say that. I came here to lift your spirit up. That's the righteous man. Four, 7 times. But the Lord will lift him up. For many are the afflictions of the righteous. The Lord delivered them from it all. For 1,000 shall fall at our side. 10,000 at our right hand. But it shall not come near us. Why, Jehovah? It's our refuge, our rock, our fortress. He's our banner. He's our rock tower. Just lift up your right hand. You are going to declare. That is going to be our prayer tonight. That, oh Lord, as my hands are lifted up, in this fire conference, this oil conference, let not my enemies one day say, look at him, look at his end. He served the Lord, but look at how wretched is he. Look at his end. They will never say, lift up your right hand, say, my father. Are you ready to pray? Say, my father, I shall lift my hands towards you. I declare your word into being, that from henceforth no enemy will say bad things to my life. They will not say, I started well, but I have ended badly. They will not say, I died. But this sickness, they will not say, my end was miserable. You know your challenges. Like David. You go and read Psalm 35. It talks about how people have risen against him. Psalm 35 verse 1. He said, plead my cause. Oh Lord, with them that strive with me, fight against them. He went to a lot. And the enemy, I think the verse 15, please help me. Anyway, he said, but in my adversity, rejoice. You are going to lift your hands. Anymore. Let them not say that I have served the Lord, but look at my end. Let them not say in the midst of everything, lift up your hands. I don't know what trouble. calls you. But the next 5 minutes, declare by the word of the Lord, that, oh Lord, let not my enemy, let them not say, I end up being broke. Lift up your hands and begin to pray. Lift up your voice. 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 Oh Lord, let them not say. Let them not say. Let them not say. I started well, but I have ended badly. Let them not say. Great family. Started well, but that is your end. Let them not say. They have remained in one branch. Let them not say. Lift up your voice. Oh Lord. Oh Lord. Oh Lord. Let them not say. Hey. Lift up your voice. 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 Listen. I want somebody to pray from his heart. You are lifting your hands towards God. Say, oh Lord, let not my enemies rejoice in what I'm going through. If you are single for years, Lord, let them not say, no man love him. He has been single. If you have married, he can give birth. Oh Lord, let them not say, yes, he married, but he hasn't can give birth. Let them not say, are you listening to me? Say, oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Shout, oh Lord,
oh Lord,
as I lift my hands towards you,
towards you.
I declare
by your word,
that let not
my enemies
rejoice
over
my adversity. Let them not say, this is how far I have ended. Lift your hands and begin to talk to the Lord. Lift up your voice. 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 Let them know, sir. Let them know, sir. Let them know, sir. Let them not say, Jesus. Jesus. Listen for us. In Jesus' name. Say, oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Let them begin to say.
Let them begin to say.
He was nobody.
He was nobody.
But God.
But God
has made him somebody.
Has made him somebody.
Let them begin to say.
Let them begin to say.
He went through a lot. But the Lord.
But the Lord
has vindicated him.
Has vindicated him.
Say, oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Let them begin to say.
Let them begin to say.
The Lord is with me. Lift your voice and pray. 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 Lift up your voice. Lift your voice. In my challenges. Are you listening to me? He said, let them shout for joy. For God is magnified. Say, Heavenly Father. Listen, be serious. As my hands are lifted up, let my enemies begin to say that God has magnified. In the challenges that I went through. 3 minutes, lift up your hands. 3 minutes. And begin to talk to the Lord. Talk to the Lord. Let them begin to magnify. Let them say. This is my confession. This is my declaration. That the Lord has magnified. In my challenges. The Lord should magnify in your challenges. The Lord should magnify. Lift up your voice. And weep. May your secret tears be heard tonight by God.
Amen.
Somebody said he will sell his chairs.
I laugh.
Because my enemies are not God. Are you listening to me? And that was my prayer. Lord, magnify in what I'm going through. Tell somebody your enemies haven't seen anything yet. Tell somebody the Lord will surely magnify in your problem. Can we dream with
that one?
Lift your two hands. Lift your two hands to the Lord. Oh, yeah, me potency. Me chamni me kwa kobiya. Oh, baby, check. Adam Fosa. Na Yesu. Come on, let's sing again. Oh, baby, check. Adam Fosa. Na Yesu. Lift your two hands to the Lord. Oh, yeah, Adam Fosa.
Decided
the papa.
The devil will toss you here. Are you listening to me? Amen and amen.
Amen.
So the king then sent, that is Solomon here.
Solomon
sent for Shema and told him, build a house here in
Jerusalem
and live here, but don't step outside. You can build, but don't move from your house. Many of us, that is how our destiny is. Marry, start a business, but to go far in business,
no.
Come to church. It's okay. But to excel in life. No way. It says, build a house here. But don't step outside the city to go anywhere else. Somebody say, my enemies.
My enemies.
I will go out.
I will step out.
From your restrictions. Are you listening to me?
Many
people, that is how your destiny is. There can be some limitations and restrictions. Let's go. On the day. You so much as cross the Kindred Valley. You shall surely die. I'm somebody who is bedridden now. Very close person to me. That I said knows. For 2.5 months, he can't move. The father died at the age of 54. So when it came to, because all his brothers are also dying at that stage. So when the 54th anniversary came, he told me. And I told him, don't be afraid. Unfortunately, I think fear gripped him. And he was knocked down. 3 months. He has a lot. But he can't move. The enemy has set a day on certain people's life that you can't cross beyond. Tonight, we are going to pray. The one of the things that anointing does is that it helps us to fight. So David in Psalm 18 verse 39.
David, when you do what you change, what you say,
thou gilded me with strength for battle.
What they
and that strength here talks about the anointing to battle.
What's that?
We are going to pray that any restriction set around our
legacy
tonight, by the special grace of God, by the anointing we have received, we are stepping out. Somebody shout, I am stepping out.
I am stepping out.
Somebody shout, I am stepping out.
I am stepping out.
From my enemies.
From my enemies.
Restrictions. Around my life.
Around my life.
Say, I am stepping out.
I am stepping out.
I am going far. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Help me, please.
Kase enana twi
mi
pie afremo en se piara opone fo no ade atome so ade atwa me ho ahia enna anadwi mi pie afremo ewo yesu dem
se any restriction,
any restriction
set around my destiny
by the evil one,
today.
Today,
by the special grace,
by the special grace of
the Lord,
of the Lord,
I defy it. I step out, and I declare,
that
He cannot kill me.
He cannot destroy me.
Clap your hands and pray. Clap your hands and pray. Clap your hands and pray. Clap your hands. Clap your hands. I am stepping out. By the name of Jesus, the church is stepping out. Let's fight.
family. Step it out. Step it out. Step it out. From the enemy's resources. I'm stepping out. Step it 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 out. Listen.
Now, oil is too much in this environment. I want you to believe God that you are coming out from certain restrictions. Don't stand in one place. Add prophetic action that by the name of Jesus, I defy my enemy's orders. Sanctions and embargoes he has placed around my life. I defy it.
Yes,
and I'm stepping out.
Jesus.
Where the enemy says, I can't cross tonight.
Yes,
I am crossing. Somebody say, where my enemy said, I can't cross.
I
stand in the name of Jesus.
And I defy it.
And I cross it. Shout, I cross it. Say, I am stepping out.
I cross
the enemy boundary, the enemy restriction around my destiny, my finance, my spiritual life. I am stepping out. Clap your hands and pray. Hey, lift your voice. Lift your voice. Step out. 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 Defy it. Defy it. The enemy cannot kill you. The enemy cannot kill you. Hey, lift up your voice. 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 Are you praying? Are you praying? All of us are. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Lift your voice. By the special grace. By the special grace. By the special grace. I am stepping out. Defiance. 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 Jesus. Don't joke. Don't joke. Take a step. Say, I step out.
I step out.
Take a step. Take a step.
To an among.
Say, by the name of Jesus.
By the name of Jesus.
I step out.
I step out.
From where the enemy,
where the enemy
has positioned me.
Has positioned me.
Say, I step out.
I step out.
I defy.
I defy.
The enemy's orders.
The enemy's orders.
Say, in this set day,
the devil
have set
around my destiny.
I defy that day.
I defy it.
Shout, I am stepping out. Say, I break
the enemy territory,
the enemy limitations. I go beyond the restrictions of my enemies. Help me, G. Help me, G. Shout, I'm stepping out.
I'm stepping out.
Shout, I am stepping out.
I'm stepping out.
From every restriction.
From every restriction.
Limitation.
Limitation.
Boundaries.
Boundaries.
Set around.
Set around.
My destiny.
My destiny.
By the evil one.
By the evil one.
Say, I defy.
I defy.
The enemy orders.
The enemy orders.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Let your hands and bless Just give him praise. 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 Lift up his voice. Lift up your voice and just celebrate him. Thank you, Lord. I want us to pray another prayer. Then I hand over. I feel like it's an all night. Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 18. I want the NLT. It says for see. Everybody say see. Tell somebody watch me. Tell another person watch me. Now shake somebody and say watch me, watch me.
Watch me, watch me.
It says see. I have made you like I'll make you strong. Let your hands and say, Lord, make me strong.
Lord, make me strong.
Make me stronger.
Make me stronger
than all my enemies.
Say
in this oil conference. Grant me a special oil.
Grant me a special oil.
That will make me strong.
That will make me strong.
Stronger in the realm.
Stronger in the realm
of the spirit.
Of the spirit.
Like a fortified city.
They say abandoned thing
that can never be captured.
You'll
be surprised that many Christians carelessness, their destiny has been captured by the enemy. Witches can capture a church. They can capture the whole choir. It says the Lord has made me like a fortified
city.
You are going to pray and release yourself from any demonic capturing. You are declared that you can never be captured. Whatever has been captured is released tonight. I say whatever
Jesus
is captured by the evil one,
yes,
is released.
Amen.
I didn't hear somebody say amen.
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 Whatever is captured. It's a for see today. Like a fortified sheet that can never say by the special grace of the Lord.
By the special grace of the Lord.
I can never be captured.
I can never be captured.
My soul can never be captured.
My soul can never be captured.
Demons cannot capture my children.
Demons cannot capture my children.
Kidnappers cannot capture my children. Say the enemy cannot capture my blessing. Say I refuse to be captured.
I refuse to be captured.
Say whatever,
whatever
is captured,
is captured
by the evil one,
by the evil one,
unknowingly,
unknowingly,
I decree
a release.
Somebody a release.
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 Say I refuse.
I refuse
to be captured.
To be captured.
Say witches.
Witches
cannot capture my soul.
My soul.
They cannot capture.
They cannot capture
my blessing.
My blessing.
They cannot capture.
They cannot capture
my marriage.
My marriage.
They cannot capture my business.
My business.
Say I refuse.
I refuse
to be captured.
As I clap my hands, so shall you be. Prayer.
Kabada badala gada bahada kabada bahada gada bada rakabrata badada gada bada kabada shada
gada gada
baranda badada bada gada kabada shabada
I cannot capture
badada bada gada bada yarda gada bada gada
lisa voice
baranda badada gada bada
lisa voice
yarda gada bada gada bada kabada
I cannot capture
baranda badada gada
my soul. Yeah, I got up.
Yagadapa, 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 Baratapa, Bashadaba, Bashadaba, Bayagada, Ragadapa, Ragadapa, Yagadapa, Yagadapa, Bashadaba, Yagadapa, Ragadada, Ragadapa, Baradada, Bayadada, Bagadada, Baratapa, Bagadada. We are still, listen to me. The enemy captures a lot. Now, in Song of Solomon, chapter 4, verse 1, and the NLT, there is one thing you must always believe God that it cannot be captured from you. Song of Solomon, chapter 4, verse 9,
verse 9.
You see, thou hast refreshed my heart. No, I want the other translation. You have the other. I say NLT. Okay. You have captured my heart. My treasure. My bride. Don't go and use it to test anyone. You hold it hostage with one glance of your eyes. With a single jaw of your necklace. But the first one, do you know that somebody can capture your heart? The heart is for the Lord. Bible says, guide your heart with all diligence. Out of it cometh the issue of life.
A man
can capture your heart. A woman can capture your heart. When your heart is captured, as
we are
sitting here, you don't concentrate. It's only the person. Some of you, your heart is captured by mobile
phones.
When the devil wants to get you, capture your heart. This is a treasure. Are you listening to me? Lift up your right hand. Say, I left my heart.
I left my hand.
Before the Lord. Say, I declare
that I cannot be captured.
My heart cannot be captured. My children cannot be captured.
My children cannot be captured.
My blessing cannot be captured.
My blessing cannot be captured.
My glory cannot be captured.
My glory cannot be captured.
My prayer life
cannot be captured
in the name of Jesus. Say,
whatever
is being captured
is being captured.
I demand
unconditional
release in Jesus' name. Let the oil go, please. I want everybody to touch it.
2 minutes.
If you have an oil, just pour a bit. Nowadays, be careful not to take people's oil. Because some people, some of the oil, when it touched you, it registered you to the scum of the enemy. Careful, don't take anybody. Not every Christian is Christian. Some of us are walking everywhere, taking strange oils. Listen to me. It attracts. When Isaac was blessing
Jacob,
one of the things he said is that my son, the smell around you is like the land in which God has blessed. That means blessing has a smell. Are you listening to me? Anointing has a fragrance. It attracts good things. Hello? You don't need makeups to get a good husband. You need the grace and the anointing of the Lord. Are you listening to me? Lift up your oil. Give me some. That's my last prayer. Thank you, Lord. I want
to pray. Just begin 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 to pray. Prophesy. Declare that the power of God, the presence of the Holy Ghost, will take over. Will take over in this oil. Take over.
Zopaka Bragaduske de Brihata, Antadi Katuske Tedebiha, Bakazopa, Ika di Bahata, Matibranta Pakatuske Bretta,
Jesus,
Nepatushe Teke.
Stretch off your hands here. Father, we lift this oil before you. To the pure, all things are pure.
Yeah, and
what
Tenona, and what
we consecrate this oil. We set it apart for the use of yours. May the fire of your presence touch it, Lord. As it touch our destiny, may our destiny, the oil in our lives, begin to attract destiny helpers, uncommon favors, uncommon opportunities, undeserved breakthroughs. And may our destiny be lifted into a higher ground. In the precious name of our Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Now lay it on your head. Say with me. Say, by this anointing. Oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Let my life.
From henceforth.
Attract. Divine destiny helpers. Destiny helpers. Now listen to me. People go in for things to sell. We don't need that. The anointing can attract
customers.
Are you listening to me? We don't push our life through to be blessed. Blessing comes to us. Goodness and mercy, we should not chase it. It should follow us. Say, Heavenly Father, by this oil, by this anointing,
from henceforth,
let my life,
my destiny,
let my life,
attract,
destiny helpers.
Uncommon favors.
Uncommon opportunities. Uncommon breakthrough.
Oh Lord.
Let my life.
Attract.
Anointing for attraction.
Anointing for attraction.
Let the fragrance.
Of this anointing.
Bring sources.
Promotion.
Breakthroughs.
Into my life.
Say
it
for me.
Your
life should begin to attract destiny helpers, uncommon favors, divine opportunities, anointing for attraction should come upon your life. The aroma around you, the aroma of blessing, fragrance of blessing.
Christo Dim.
Let that aroma that came around Jacob. Let better offer it. The aroma and the fragrance of blessings. Let it rest. 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 Let it rest of our life. In the name of Jesus. Lift your two hands. Say, Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
Let the presence.
Let the presence
of the Holy Spirit.
Of the Holy Spirit.
Take over.
Take over.
Say, Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
I give you all.
I give you all.
As you take over.
As you take over.
Say, I give you all.
I give you all.
My challenges.
My challenges.
As you take over.
As you take over.
Let your presence.
Let your presence.
Let the anointing.
Let the anointing.
Rest on my life.
Rest on my life.
Right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Right now.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Lift your two hands. Father, I thank you, Lord. I bless you for the life of your people. I declare that from henceforth, may this oil begin to attract promotions, favors. Destiny help us.
Amen.
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 In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
At every given stage in my life, when I see difficulties, the Lord sent a helper in my life. May the Lord from henceforth, in this oil conference, cause your life to be attracted to destiny and help.
Amen.
Destiny help us.
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 Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
No one from henceforth
God
will say,
like I said,
you started well,
what shall I say,
but you have ended badly.
When we hear the portal,
no one will say,
Bianca said,
you used to be fire for the Lord, but you have backslided. The Lord will not let them say, since you started coming to church, you haven't seen anything. May no one laugh at your adversity. May the Lord cause your enemies begin to rejoice. As Sarah said, those that laugh at me is now laughing with me. May this be your portion. May this be your testimony. Receive it! In the name of our Lord Jesus. Lift your two hands and bless God. Lift up your two hands. Lift up your two hands. Lift up your two hands and bless him. Give him all the glory. Give him the glory. Give him praise. Just bless the name. Let the Lord be magnified tonight. Let the Lord be magnified tonight. Let the Lord be exalted. We give her the praise. We give her the praise, God. Lift up your voice. Amen. Just take your seat.
I'll bless you with trust.
I know few churches, when it comes to their annual conventions, they don't necessarily have to raise funds. Because there are people, the moment the program began, for consult your pastor. I want to see whether you're ready. You want ministers, five great servants. Please support him. Who is coming? First person. You can bring it on Sunday or today. Nowadays, I don't like pledges. Pastor, when they pledge. So please, 100 Ghana. I need about 10 to 20 people. Just support. Who's coming? Who's coming? God bless you. Who's coming? Follow, please. Please. 100 Ghana. Now, the man of God says something. He said, when he died, you know, he had a lorry accident. Now, they allowed him to go to Pastor One. Next year, he will come. I would like you to host him here. Yeah, I would like you to host him here. It's one of the challenge programs we have ever had. From the time he died, he left the body. He was made to go through different halls. Every hall is crying you. Now, the halls they made him to go through is there is only two languages there. Proceed. Depart. And you see, people ahead when he entered into the hall of salvation, because he came to a place where there was a junction. Now, there was a thick demon standing in a road. He said, the road is very beautiful. And most of the people were naked. And he was on the queue. Initial stage, he was the queue with the shadow. It was his testimony that made me understand why our shadow followed us. So when they got to the place, a shadow left him. Then he came to a junction. And one of the road was very beautiful. Flowers were everywhere. And there was a tall hill demon, very dark. You see the demon, you get scared immediately. And he was laughing. And majority of people, when you go there, you see, when you die, your will is no more. You are being controlled. But the other road, he was made to turn to. Only about few people. And he went forward and saw a very big place. And they have written the Hall of Salvation. And he met a lot of dying souls there. But people were shaking. But you can see people scream, even though they are Christians, they scream you. The Hall of Forgiveness, you go through there, and they will scream you that before you died, you were not having any problem with anyone. If you have any little thing, depart. And they came through the Hall of Giving. And people who doesn't pay their tithes and giving, a lot of them. No, this is not a... I purposely brought him because I read his book. So don't take Christianity lightly. Some of us, when it comes to God, we become very hard. 100 Ghana, please, as many. Let me pray with you. Come, as many. As many. Wow. I know this is a great church. Who is coming again? Pastor, I hope you can bring it tomorrow. Please, or Sunday. Please, God bless you. God bless you. 100 Ghana. 100 Ghana. 100 Ghana. 100 Ghana. You don't need to have it all before you give. God bless you. And who's coming again? Okay, 50 Ghana. Add it to rate and let me go. 50 Ghana. Serious. 50 Ghana. Wow. and support it. Come and support it. God bless you. Who is coming? As many. Where are the youth? Where are the youth? As many, please. 50 Ghana. Who is coming? Father, I left them before heaven. May today be a memorial in the history of their life. Out of all their givings, may this be a sweet incense, fragrance in your nostrils. And out of this, may uncommon and unusual blessings, favors rest upon them. Between this time and the end of the year, I pray for divine surprise. Lord, surprise them. In Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Amen.
Please. Good. Who is also coming? 20 Ghana, I want everybody. Please come and let me pray with you. 20 Ghana. 20 Ghana. As of all, your people are surprising me.
Wow.
20 Ghana. 20. Great family. I have my reserved respect for this church. Don't disappoint me. Is coming 20 Ghana. As many. The young one with big phones and high heels. Please come. Let's. Who is coming? I want 10 more. 10 more. Please come. 10 more. 10 more. 20 Ghana for the Lord. Ghana for the Lord. Just support the program. 20 Ghana. 20 Ghana. All the youth. What are the members of the choir? Choir, ushers, what are they? The nice protocols with very good big stilt. Father, I bless your people. I declare, Lord, every restrictions placed around their destiny is overpowered by the finger of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, fresh oil for financial empowerment, let them rest on there. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Then 50 people of 10 Ghana. 50 people, 10 Ghana. And let me leave. 50 people. God bless you all for coming. I need 50 people. 50. 50 people. 50. 10 Ghana. Oh, when you know what I'm in Mumbai. 50 Ghana. Sorry, 10 Ghana. I need 50 people. Those are the back. You are part of the service. 10 Ghana.
10
Ghana. 10
Ghana.
10 Ghana. 10 Ghana. 10 Ghana. Who is coming again? I need about 5 people more. Father, blessed is the man that fear your name and that delight greatly in your commandments. The children of such persons, scripture says, shall be mighty on earth. The generation of the upright shall be blessed. And wealth and riches will never depart from such house. That is my prayer for them. That wealth and riches will never depart from their house. May their generation be great. Whatever they have sold, Lord, remember them. In Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you all. Help me welcome your pastor. Put your hands together. Protocol to the office. Be on your feet. Put your hands together for the man of God. Amen. Amen. What a wonderful night. Keep clapping. Keep clapping. Keep clapping. Powerful. Take your seat for just a minute. And the rest, if you have 5 CDs in your pocket, 2 CDs in your pocket, 1 CD in your pocket, come and put it in the bowl. Hurry up. Let me prophesy. Just look at my eyes. Look at my eye with your right hand. I declare by the finger of the Lord that by the end of this convention, somebody here, your testimony will come. Your amen look pulled down. The loudest amen receive a fastest miracle. I declare in the name of Jesus that there is somebody here before tomorrow morning by 6 o'clock, your testimony will arrive. Lift your right hand again. I declare in the name of Jesus that tomorrow morning by 6 o'clock, there is somebody here, a testimony will be announced at your doorstep. I need the loudest amen. The loudest amen receive a fastest miracle. No way. The loudest will receive a fastest miracle. I declare by the hand of the Lord and by the power of the Holy Ghost, wherever they bury your testimony has come. Wherever they bury your breakthrough has come. Receive it in the name of Jesus. That says the Lord that there is somebody here, a prophecy has been fulfilled in your life tonight. I declare favor is released. Glory is released. In the name of Jesus, I declare after tonight you begin to do exploit. I say you begin to do exploit. I see you going forward. You are possessing your possession. Your testimony has come. Your miracle has been released. Your testimony, your destiny has been connected. Receive it in the name of Jesus. I declare. Every yoke placed upon your destiny have been broken down. Limitation placed upon your destiny have been broken down. You are going forward. You are going forward. Look at my eyes. Look at my eyes. Let me tell you something. Yeah, organize your program. I will be in your testimony. Should I prophesy? I said I prophesy. Look at my eyes and respond. I prophesy. I prophesy. I don't know. There is somebody after tonight. By 10 o'clock. By 10 o'clock tonight. I don't know who I'm speaking to. I say by 10 o'clock tonight. I don't know who I'm speaking to. I don't know. Your faith
When your faith says yes, nobody can say no. I prophesied over somebody here tonight. By 10 o'clock tonight, a testimony will knock at your door. See, as the Lord, three people here. I see someone dashing you a car. You didn't hear what I said. I see three people here. God giving you a car, and you can't believe it. My God shall supply all my needs. I prophesy. I declare. Hey, I see darkness being removed from your life. I declare. I don't know who I'm speaking to, but I see document, traveling document, it have been buried. But says the Lord, the document have been released upon your house tonight. I need a craziest amen like never before. I need a craziest amen. I can't see craziest amen yet. I declare. Say yes, the Lord. The hand of the enemy have been broken from your destiny. The hand of the enemy have been broken from your destiny. And whatever they bury, whatever the enemy has buried, it has been given back to you. Your promotion, your blessing, your marriage, your travel document. There is somebody here tomorrow morning, your promotion document will be given to you. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Hear this. I see twins being given to somebody right now. I see twins. I see twins. There is somebody here, you are carrying twins right now. I see twins. I declare and I prophesy into your womb that twins are being deposited in the name of Jesus. Hear me. Say as the Lord. Oshina and Opa, seven steps of yours. Seven steps of yours will usher you into your breakthrough. Give the Lord a hand. Pastor Frank will speak a word before we close. Stretch out your hand, Pastor Frank. Good. Winnie, I feel within my spirit. I see about 100 angels. 100. And they carry testimonies. I don't know who I'm talking to. That contract had been signed. No way. I don't know who I'm speaking to. That contracts have been signed. I see check. It's written in foreign currencies. It has been given to somebody among us. If you are the one, just show me to the atmosphere and catch it right now. In Jesus' name. Hey, I prophesied upon your business. I prophesied upon your finances. I declare your business will spring forth one more time. Your finances will spring forth one more time. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. Hear me? Tomorrow we are coming. Amen. Tomorrow morning and then tomorrow evening. And hear this one. Hear this very important news. Friday, Papa Adam should be in the house. Hallelujah. I know yesterday the whole place was full. And some of them have gone back to sleep because they are waiting for Papa coming Friday. Hallelujah. And it's going to be awesome because, come on, Papa will lay hands upon everyone here. So I'm inviting each and every one of you. Amen. We continue with the calling. Amen and amen. So tomorrow morning, prophetic service moment from 6 to 9. And then tomorrow night, the program continues. You got to be here tomorrow night. Amen. You got to be here. Amen. God bless you, Auntie KK. God bless your fire. Amen. Pastor, speak away.
Let's close our eyes and lift up our right hands into the heavens. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you, O God, for the oil for exploit. In the name of Jesus, even as your people are going out there, may your favor go with them. In the name of Jesus, may they go out there and come back with testimonies. In the name of Jesus, as they step out there, may doors be open unto them. May financial doors be open unto your people. In the name of Jesus, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, As they go out there, may their little ones become thousands in the name of Jesus. And we meet here tomorrow morning, oh God, we say thank you for what you will be doing in our lives. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Come on, put your hands here. The Bachelor Manager, Reverend Steve, envelope no diaba, Uji Bia diaba, Uji envelope ni Bia diaba, Pacho Fabetua. Ochina Najo, Ahabe putu, is going to be prayer and warfare. Amen. Five lopunitum, God bless you. Amen. Are you coming tomorrow morning and tomorrow night? Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord. Tell somebody you are blessed.